In this video, see how the ASP.NET MVC Grid Lookup Editor allows end users to easily locate and select values from a drop-down grid, which contains lookup items. The grid view is seamlessly embedded into the editor's drop-down window, providing powerful and customizable data processing, data representation options for your lookups, such as sorting, grouping, multi-selection, filtering, templates, and more. In this project, I have an empty view and a data model generated using the Entity Framework with a database-first approach. Here, you can see the fields of the Employee class. The embedded grid updates its contents using callbacks, so I need to define the grid lookup inside a partial view and then define how the callbacks will be routed back to my controller. So within the view, I place a link to the partial view that will contain the grid lookup. Then I go to the controller code. Within the controller code, I add a new action that will handle the grid lookup's callbacks. Then I right-click the newly added action and select Add View. In the open dialog, I check the Create as a Partial View option and click the Add button. The partial view opens. Here, I define the grid lookup extension. Within the extension settings, I need to define the callback route values. Here, I add new callback route values to the home controller and to the grid lookup partial action. Now I'll add the required columns to the embedded grid. Here I want to add the following columns by their field names: first name, last name, birth date, and city. I should also specify the key field name. I return to the controller code. Here, I define the data context and pass the list of retrieved values to the view as a model. I also pass this list to the partial view as a model. In the partial view, I bind the grid lookup extension to the model using the bindList method. Let's take a look at the result in the browser. Here you can see the fully functional grid lookup extension. I can invoke the drop-down window that contains a grid bound to our model data. I can click any item row within the grid, and this item will be selected and displayed within the text area. Let's modify the grid lookup extension. I return to Visual Studio and increase the extension width up to 300 pixels. Define the format string of the selected item, and define the display format string of the date time column. And let's take a look at the result. Now the date time values are displayed in a more readable format. The selected item is displayed as first name, second name, and from city. For example, Janet Leverling from Kirkland or Nancy DeVolio from Seattle. I'll return to Visual Studio. Now we can enable filtering, and the entered filter will be automatically applied. And let's take a look at the result. I can enter the filtering value into the text box, and the filter will be applied quickly. The filter applies to all the columns. For example, I can find all the employees from London. I can also sort the items within the grid by any column. And that's it. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.